love to hear this man speak. So I know this man will bless you this evening.
Amen.
So, Brother Cables, of Miles Chapel Fielding Church in Tyler, Texas, I present to some, present to others. But he is a man that I can testify to that. And so I know that we're in for a treat today. So, Brother Cables, I want you to come and preach the word in your own way. And give us what God has given you.
Amen.
Let us give him a hand clap. Amen. Amen.
Great is the Lord who is worthy to be praised.
Amen.
Psalmist said, "Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name."
Yes, sir.
Amen.
And we thank God for this day. We thank God for Reverend Linda McCullough. Amen. The shepherd of this flock. And we lift her up in our prayers and keep her in our thoughts, that God's hand will be upon her and that God will renew her strength. That when she returns the valley grove, she will return with the fire that is much more intense than what it is right now. And so I want to do a couple of things. The cards will come up in just a moment. Let me have my lovely wife and son wish you a good
day.
Isn't she lovely?
Yes, she is.
She puts up with my three children are here with us all three of you this afternoon. I'll stand up real quick. Siobhan is at the end of Genesis. And now, get the Miles Chapel Signature Church. You all stand up. You are Miles Chapel. Stand up and go.
Thank you. Yeah. Come into time.
up in the top. We don't fear it now. Hopefully you say the lifetime we get here. There's time. Time is an essence. It is the space allotted for the manipulation of the atmosphere and its components to execute the will of God. Let me say it again. Time, in essence, is the space allotted for the matriculation of the atmosphere and its components to execute the will of God. In other words, God created all things for an ultimate purpose. God is sovereign, and our mind cannot grasp the totality of what God has set in place before the foundation of the world. The task of humanity is to live to its capacity with a mindset on the will of God. And so we have to wrestle through the reality of what is, but not yet. And so we really can't fathom. We can't fathom the true majesty of God. We can't comprehend such an undeniable sovereign God who reigns throughout eternity. But however, we have been made privy to the mysteries of God through Jesus the Christ. Ephesians chapter number 1 and verse number 9 says, Having made known unto us the mystery of his will, according to his good pleasure, which he had purposed in himself. It is now, though we cannot explain the awesomeness of God through our faith, we know that God is.
Yes.
And so we have the responsibility to live in the experience of what is to come. And so we engage in time with a mindset that God is up to something. We engage in the moment with the mindset that greater is coming. And so because we are convinced that greater is coming, our lives ought to be dedicated to living it out in the time that has been allotted. And so it is because some things remain a mystery, you must stay in tune. In other words, you must stay in sync with the things of God. And so it is as you remain in sync with God that you flow with God. And so you are so aware that you don't miss the kairos moments. In other words, those moments that have the potential to modify your life.
Yeah.
You have to. You have no time to wait the enemy out. You must actively engage in the time at hand. In other words, there are some people who are merely sitting and they're waiting for the enemy to move on. I want to tell you one thing. If you're waiting for the enemy to move on, you're going to be waiting your entire life. Because the Bible lets us know that the enemy is like an ever-roaring lion. And he's walking about seeking whom he may devour. And so if you're waiting the enemy out, you're giving the enemy the power to take your mind off the things of God. And so we're waiting for the kingdom to come, but we must understand that we must live out the time as the kingdom is coming. I'm going to help somebody here. And so he says, redeem the time. And so redeeming the time means that you have made a decision to seize the moment. In other words, we must make a decision to make use of the time. You have made a decision to be involved in the moment for the moment, not for the moment to involve you. Understand this, in previous chapters, Paul is trying to get the church at Ephesus to align themselves with the righteousness of God. And he wanted them to know that they were representatives of Jesus the Christ. They were not to walk as though they were ignorant of Jesus. They were to live in the light of God. It is their awareness of God that the people bring glory to God through their living. And so when you are in relationship with God, you dig deep. deep down to make a firm commitment that no matter what comes your way, you are sold out for Jesus.
You make a decision
and live it out in life. You cannot sit in amazement, but the amazement has to drive you to the fulfillment of God's purpose here on earth. Remember now, when Jesus was ascending, the angels said to the people, why are you standing here? Why are you gazing? Because the same Jesus will come back in like manner. They were stuck in the event taking place rather than being engaged in the meaning and the purpose of what was happening. And so now, so many people, I believe, are gazing. Many people are passing the time. So many people have made a decision to live day by day. This is why living from paycheck to paycheck is so dangerous. All you're waiting for is the next paycheck. You get up, you go to work, okay, it's payday. And in other words, let us go back to work. Let us focus on the things of God. Because when you have the ability to have something left over, you look forward to engaging in the moment rather than thinking about the work. And there are so many people thinking about trying to make it because the enemy has captured your mind and captured your spirit. But I've come today to pull you into time, to pull you into your purpose, to know that God has a plan greater than what you think.
Yeah.
Understand this, that redeeming the time means that you make use of your time. That means you know that time exists as a gift from God. And you understand that you have a choice to use it or to waste it. You understand that this moment will never come again, because opportunities come and opportunities go. And so you have the choice to let it pass or to seize the moment. God needs some people, some blood-washed believers to seize the moment. Remember now, when Joshua was given the command to lead the people to the promised land, the Bible says that he went to the people and he said, prepare ye victuals, for in 3 days you shall cross over the Jordan. Hear this now. He told the people to get ready. In other words, he was trying to get them to seize this moment that God had before them. So look at somebody, don't seize the moment. You know, some of us are looking for a big sign. Some of us are looking for the sky to open. Some of us are looking for the blinds to move and the windows to lift up. But I need you to tell you this. If you're looking for that stuff, you just might miss God.
Yay.
The time. Secondly, redeeming the time means that you understand what is before you. In other words, you can proceed with understanding what is taking place. You understand that there are seasons.
Yes.
You understand that there are seasons in which struggles are more fierce than others.
Yes.
There are times and other times that we prosper more than before. And so you don't just go through the motions. You don't just cruise along. But you actively engage in the moment.
Yeah.
Remember, Jesus was in the garden. Remember, and Jesus was in the garden, and the disciples were sleeping.
Uh-huh.
They were so unaware of the upcoming events that they were sleeping away the time. They were not aware of the time or the season. It was not a time to sleep, but it was a time to be on guard. And if we're talking about the king is coming, don't let the king catch us off guard.
Yeah.
Let us have our hearts ready.
Yeah.
Let us have our spirits ready to receive him when he comes.
Yeah.
You must understand that this is a season to not only be on guard, but a season to take action. It's not enough to talk about what is taking place.
is a time in the earth that believers of Jesus Christ have got to rise up and be the church. We must actively engage in the shifting of the dynamics of the shifting of the system, and we must actively engage in the filling of the earth with the aroma of Christ. Remember, Paul says, now thanks be unto God, which always causes us to triumph in Christ and make it manifest the Savior of his knowledge by us in every place. For we are unto God a sweet fragrance of Christ in them that are saved and in them that are perishing. I want to ask the question, what are you releasing into the atmosphere?
Well,
what are people smelling? What are people seeing as they encounter your presence?
Well,
I know you're going to help somebody here in a minute. The fragrance drives you. And it draws others to the great things of God. For it is now, for whenever my worship enters the atmosphere, the warring angels of God move into action. Y'all going to help myself here. When the word of God hits the atmosphere, the mighty spirit of God comes as a mighty rushing wind to prick the hearts of the people who turn from their wicked ways, turn their lives over to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And this is merely a shifting of the mindset to greater things. Have you ever seen somebody just turn their life around completely? It is because they have come into an intimate relationship with Christ. They have got a glimpse of God's glory, and in their spirit, they are convinced that greater is coming. They are convinced that there is more to life than this. They are convinced there is more than church than this. They are convinced that something great and awesome is on the way. And so they no longer live ignorant of the time, but carefully examine the environment and seeking to release the glory of God in the earth. You're ready to hit my last point. If you haven't caught me yet, you better hurry up. Because dealing with the time also means that you can see beyond the moment. You can see beyond the moment. When you can see it, you are convinced, and there is nothing anybody can do about it, because you feel it, you live it, you breathe it, you speak it. Even when people doubt you, even when people doubt you and try to make you think that you are crazy, you still speak it because you can see it. Can you see? This is why King said that the king would speak with such velocity, because he could see beyond the moment. Because he said, my eyes have seen the glory and the coming of the Lord. I may not get the victory, but we are not getting the promised land. He could see that a day existed in the eternal realm, but it was not yet fulfilled here on earth. So he was able to speak people into the eternal. If you cannot imagine the moment, you go through the motions. But when you can envision, go back to the beginning. When you can envision, and when you can sense greater, in the strength, you speak greater in the midst of tragedy and turmoil. You speak into the atmosphere that greater is coming. Is there anybody in this place who thinks that greater is coming? That one Taylor, shut up. That one Taylor, stop praising them. That one Taylor, stop coming to church. But you can't stop now, because you come into time. You come into the moment that God has ordained. And you know that something is about to happen. You know that Jesus is on the way, and you can't get caught sleeping. But you gotta stay on the battlefield. You gotta trust in the Lord. You gotta keep going. And say, God, I kneel. And for God, I'm willing to die. And no weapon formed against me shall be able to prosper.
Thank you. Thank you.
the will of God. You know, most of us read our Bibles, we hear it preached, we know what the will of God is, but some of us still waiting on the devil to fulfill. And you know, the devil, like you said, is not going to fulfill.
That's right.
So we're going to have to do the moving, so we got to step a little bit higher. You see, we got to depend on the Lord to sustain us and help us to get to where we need to be. You see, even though you got troubles right now, but he was preaching, even though you got trouble, you got to praise your way out of it.
Yes.
You see, don't just sit there and say, Lord, have mercy. Y'all say, thank you, Lord, for what you're about to do.
Yes.
You ought to be praising God for the miracle that he's about to bring to you.
Thank you.
Baptist Church, Myron Park, Texas, celebrating first year service. Pastor Hiawatha Graves, April 24, 2016, at 3 p.m.
I just rose to say that I did video the service, and I will be putting it on YouTube, entitled Valley Grove, and whatever the title is of the program. I'll have it on there by tomorrow. Valley Grove Homecoming, okay.